Hi guys, Rest Enjoy here. Welcome to the first episode of NPC Flee AI tutorial. This will be a 4-episode tutorial. In the first episode, we will discuss the algorithm with general concept without any implementation. In the second episode, we'll implement a fleeing algorithm using a free pet finding asset. By the end of second episode, we'll have an NPC AI which works more than 90% of the time. In the third episode, we'll improve it to be recursive and work asynchronously, so it will make better decisions for not being cornered and work much quicker. And finally, in the fourth episode, we will use machine learning, so it will learn to flee on the run. So let's go ahead and start discussing the algorithm. Okay, so you're developing an NPC game, and now it's turn to tell that covers where to run. But in order to tell them where to run, first you should figure how would you run away from a threat. There are many factors which should be taken into account when running from someone. We'll call these the fundamental conditions, so let's cover the fundamental conditions one by one. First, how far do you and the threat know? To calculate where to run perfectly, you need to know about the whole map. Without knowing the whole map, you might run toward a direction which would seem safe at first, but could lead you to a corner or right in the hands of more dangerous target. On the other hand, most of the time you don't want your NPC to know everything. You want to make wrong decisions and die sometimes. So you should provide them a radius and make them calculate the escape route in that zone. Second, are you running away from only one or multiple enemies? When there is only one threat to run away from, it's relatively straightforward. But if there are multiple threats, you have to assess how dangerous each of them are. This includes how fast and how strong each one of these targets. 3. Are you cornered? If you are in an open field, usually you just run in the opposite direction from the threat. But in case you are cornered, you might want to run toward the third way until passing an edge, then go to the exact opposite direction of the enemy. This should be taken into account together with how well do you know the map, because you might not know about the corner. 4. Is there a safe zone? If you're in the middle of nowhere, it really doesn't matter where you run as long as you are running away from the threat. But in some cases, you might want to take refuge in a safe zone or an ally. Also, you could try to distract the enemy by leading it towards a more tempting target. 5. How much time do you have for calculation? While you are calculating the best escape route, the clock is ticking. If you try to be too smart about where to run, you might find yourself shouting, I found it, and hearing the echo inside of your enemy's stomach. To avoid that, you have to put a limit on calculation time, because it's impossible to find the best way immediately. Implementation of this differs between synchronous and asynchronous programming, but we will get to that in the third episode. 6. Is the terrain homogeneous? Let's say you run too slow, but you're good at swimming, and the threat runs faster than you, but swims slower than you. In that case, jumping in the water might make more sense than running on the road, despite keeping you closer to the threat for some time. 7. Are the threats melee or range? Before getting into that, I need to explain two terms: road distance and air distance. Air distance is the length of the straight line between two points. It's really easy to calculate since it doesn't take the terrain or obstacles into account. Road distance, in turn, is the actual length you have to pass through for reaching a target. If the road is wiggly, it might be much greater than the air distance. Now, if you are fleeing from a melee threat, you just have to keep your road distance. But escaping from a ranged threat is a little bit trickier, since you cannot just keep your road distance, you have to take air distance into account as well. 8. Last but not least, is breaking the line of sight going to help you? If yes, by how much? You might prefer running in a zigzag pattern, sacrificing your road distance just to get out of the enemy's sight. This way the enemy might lose your track. This one should be taken into account with your chasing AI. If the threat always knows where you are, like Eagle Vision in Assassin's Creed, it doesn't make sense to hide behind a wall. By the way, for generating some of these videos, I used my good friend Epiphany at Night's game, which is in development right now. I highly recommend you to follow him on Twitter, link will be in the description. Now that we learned what to take into account, let's see what not to take into account. Like, are you on a quest and the quest dictates you not to run? Or dictates you to run towards somewhere to lure the threat? For example, in the Age of Empires game, the way you lure the boar to the town center. However, these kind of situations are rare and you'll ignore them for the purpose of this tutorial. You should impose this behavior to the NPC in your quest methods. Why so? Because it fits better to the single responsibility role. I'm not getting into the fundamentals of programming right now, but long story short, your fleeing AI shouldn't put its nose in the general AI business. That's it for this week. Don't forget to give a thumbs up, subscribe and activate notifications so you won't miss the following videos. Be tuned for next episode. Until then, don't forget to rest and enjoy.